Mid-drive motor, torque sensor, hub motor, cadence sensor, mid-drive, torque sensor, hub motor. By the end of this video, this is all going to make sense. Just to clarify, I see this mentioned fairly often where people assume because a bike has a mid-drive motor, a motor mounted in the center of the bike driving the cranks, that it has a torque sensor as opposed to a cadence sensor. Although that is probably more common, it can go either way. So the motor type does not affect which type of pedal assist your bike is going to have. To put it really simply, the pedal assist sensor is what takes the pedaling motion and translates that into power going to the motor. Now, before I go into the two different types and explain the differences, the pros and cons of each of them, yes, they both have pros and cons, I think it's really important to point out that this video is only to explain as best as I possibly can how they work, but to really know the difference, you have to ride the bikes. I would highly recommend riding both types of bikes and seeing which one you prefer. How do they ride? What do they feel like? Because that's something that you have to experience, and I don't feel like I can convey on camera, but I'm gonna try. So let's start with a cadence sensor. What does that actually mean? On the Bolton eBikes Avenger here, the sensor is located right here on the bottom bracket. You can see there's a disc right here with some magnets on it. And then there's a little pickup sensor right here. And what this is doing is detecting when these magnets go by, when the cranks are rotating. So I'm gonna pedal backwards just so you can kind of see. But basically when you're pedaling forwards, doing the opposite of this, it's gonna see, oh, you're moving the pedals and you want to move. Now because of the sensor that's used, if you're going backwards, it actually won't kick on the pedal assist. Thankfully, it's a one-way direction only, so it's only gonna work when you're going forward. On most bikes, you have settings, typically 0 through 5, that can vary a little bit. So on 0, if I crank those pedals around, the motor is not going to turn on, nothing's going to happen. If I turn it to 1, and then I start cranking the pedals around, however, there we go, the motor kicks on and gives me some power. Now, you may notice that the motor's going pretty fast, but I'm not pedaling very hard. As long as the cranks are moving with a cadence sensor, the motor is going to give you power. It has no idea how much effort I'm actually putting in. I'm going to put on my brand new Maya 3.0 helmet from Cali Helmets, now online. So with the pedal assist on 0, I'm just pedaling around like a bicycle. I'm not getting any help from the motor at all. As soon as I turn the pedal assist to 1, like I just showed you, now the motor kicks on. Now, if I want to, I can keep the pedals going around and put in basically no effort. So it looks like I'm pedaling and working hard. I'm really not doing anything. I'm just letting the motor do all the work. And usually that's referred to as ghost pedaling. But really, I can pedal as hard as I want, as much as I want. I can change into a harder gear. If I'm going up a really steep hill and I need more power, then what I do is change this from a 1 to a 2, and that's gonna automatically increase the amount of power going to the motor. 3 is more power, 4 is a little more, and 5 is the most. That is maximum power. That's all that this particular bike has. So it's a very simple but effective system that, again, knows when you're pedaling, but it doesn't know how hard. You just adjust these settings between 0 and 5 and whatever gear you're in on the bike to make it comfortable to ride and get the amount of exercise that you want. Now, even though this bike has a motor mounted in the middle, the pedal assist works exactly the same way. Again, I have a 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pedal assist setting. The only difference is the motor is mounted here, driving the chain to the rear wheel instead of driving the rear wheel directly. The cranks, the pedals, have no idea how much effort I'm actually putting in. I can ghost pedal if I want to, I can pedal hard if I want to, but if I want more power or less power, I need to change this number right here. Now it's time to get into the torque sensors. This is the Bolton eBikes Blackbird, which has a hub motor. Now it isn't as common to see a torque sensor on a hub motor, but it certainly can be done, and that's what we have here. Now there is no magnet disc like on the Avenger. So this bottom bracket, which is this whole cartridge that fits inside the frame here, is the sensor. So instead of detecting the rotation, it's actually detecting pressure on the cranks. So I've got the bike off right now, but if I was to put pressure on this pedal right here, even if the pedal is not moving, the bike detects how much pressure I'm putting on the cranks because the sensor is built into the bottom bracket and it is going to move instantly. Now with the cadence sensor I showed you earlier, you have to rotate the pedals around a little ways before it engages and catches. So when you first start pedaling, there is a slight delay. With a torque sensor, however, the power can come on immediately. Let me show you what I mean. If I put a little pressure on the pedal, I've got the brakes on right now, so the motor is deactivated. But as soon as I let go of the brakes, you're gonna see the bike move forward, even if I keep the cranks in basically the same place. And there it goes. Just to show that a little bit more, so I have brakes on, and if I let go, boom, the bike's moving instantly. You can see that the cranks weren't moving around in a circular motion at all, just the pressure right here. In fact, this time I'll do it, brakes are off. So you'll see how soon this bike starts moving. As soon as I start putting pressure on the cranks, goes instantly. Sometimes when people hop on a bike with a torque sensor, as opposed to a cadence sensor, because the power delivery is more instant, they feel like the bike has more power, when that's not actually the case. The cadence sensor just needs at least maybe a quarter rotation or even half a rotation of the cranks before the power is able to kick on. And finally, here we have a mid-drive motor with a torque sensor. Now this is more similar to what you see on some of the higher end expensive bikes, 250 watts, mid-drive motor, torque sensor, but it's missing something, and that would be a throttle. See, you have a display like you'd have on the other bikes, you've got your shifters, but there's no throttle on this particular bike. Again, that's something that can go either way. This is a mid-drive, this has a throttle, which as you can see, doesn't need you to be pedaling to move. That's one of the cool things about having a throttle on your bike. You can get power instantly, even if you have a cadence sensor, just by pressing that button. So this is where we get into the one downside to a torque sensor. If you want more power out of this motor, you have to pedal harder. That's the only way to get more power. Now, yes, you do still have settings 0 through 5 in most cases. So a 5 setting will give you more power, for example, than a 1. But the only way to get the maximum, you know, let's say it's 250 watts out of this particular bike, even if you have it in 5, is to pedal fairly hard. If you're pedaling lightly or if you're ghost pedaling like I did on the other bike, the bike's gonna move slowly. It's not gonna give you all the power that the motor has. So by not having a throttle, effectively there's no override on a bike like this. Now this is what you're gonna see on the bikes from, you know, Specialized or Santa Cruz or Trek. They're gonna have a mid-drive motor that's torque sensing, and the only way to get the maximum power out of it is to pedal harder. The advantage to that, of course, is it feels much more natural. So if you want a bike that looks like a bicycle, rides like a bicycle, but it just adds a little bit more power to what you can naturally do, then maybe that motor is for you. The Avidar bike that I reviewed is a great example of that. Many people might not even realize this is even an e-bike, but all it does is amplify my own power. So right now I'm pedaling at a slow cadence, and if I want the bike to go faster, both between me and the motor, there's no throttle. I have to just pedal harder, and the harder I pedal, the more power the motor's gonna give me. So in a way, a torque sensing mid-drive type motor might be the most natural, the most seamless type of e-bike. But I know people who don't like bikes that are set up this way because there's effectively no override for the motor. There's no throttle where you can put more power in on certain types of torque sensing motors, And if you want more power, you just have to work harder. So which one of these is better? Leave me a comment below. Let me know which one you prefer. I know this is gonna be a little bit of a debate. You're gonna have people that say torque sensors are the best. They're the most natural. They feel the best. It's the best riding experience. But I know we're gonna have a few people who say, nope, I actually don't like torque sensors. I like the fact that I can pedal my Cadence Sensor bike very lightly and get however much power I want, no matter how much effort I'm putting in. And again, this is something that's really hard to describe. You really have to get on a bike, you have to ride them, you have to experience this for yourself. I think it's a personal preference and you could go either way. Normally, torque sensors will cost a little bit more, so you are gonna pay a premium for it. Personally, I'm a big fan of the Befang mid-drive motors like the Ultra that have all the power, they have torque sensing, and they have a throttle. To me, that's kind of a great combination of all of the different possibilities. The Lancer bike here, 1,000 watts, full suspension, fat tires, Cadence Sensor motor, because that keeps the price right under $3,000. If this was the torque sensing motor, the price would be much higher. Hopefully I've narrowed down your search somewhat. You're probably wondering, do I want a hub motor? Do I want a mid-drive? Do I want a mid-drive? Do I want a hub motor? And for that, make sure you go watch this video right here. I break down the ins and outs, the pluses, the minuses of both types of motors. If you're in Northern California, come test ride the bikes here at Bolton E-Bikes. We'd be happy to help you out.